Hey y'all, Lane on Bass here, and I wanted to take a minute to introduce you to Etta, my new Spector Coda-5. Now, Etta is the big sister to the Coda-4 Eddie that I bought last year, and I did that because I had signed up with Ryan Pelton, who is one of the world's foremost Elvis tribute artists, and since I was going to do a Jerry Chef tribute, I thought it was appropriate to have a bass that he'd be proud to play on stage. The Big Six, as much as I love it, and we've been through the wars for 16 years, it just wasn't appropriate to the gig. So I went ahead and got myself a Coda 4-string, traditional J bass, but done beautifully. And this year, I went ahead and got a backup. And since I was going to get a second one, I decided this time I would do a 5-string, and that way I could use it for more gigs, and of course I have the low notes, so I got more tonal possibilities. Now, Etta is exactly the same as Eddie, except for obviously the fifth string, but two other little details. The first one is that the headstock is color match instead of being natural blonde, and I really appreciated being able to get that option now. The other thing, actually it's not an option, but I know people are going to notice it, so I'm going to mention it. They stained the back of the neck black for me. And, you know, Stuart knows, and if you watch the video on the NS6, Stuart is very well aware that I play only black basses. And I kind of kidded with him when I got the 4-string that I hoped it was black enough because it had the blonde neck and blonde headstock. So this time around, they stained the back of the neck for me, and I really appreciated him going to the trouble of that, and it doesn't affect the playability at all or the feel. It's exactly the same as the natural neck, but it just looks better for me, so I'm happy. Another thing, and I don't know that you can see it in the camera, but on the back of the headstock of the US built instruments, Stuart hand signs every one, and part of that is the serial number. When I got my Big Six, it was serial number 016, and so is Etta. So that was really neat for me. I really appreciated that. As far as sound samples go, you know, there's so much nuance in this bass, especially with the Aguilar preamp and pickups. Just amazing system. You're not going to hear that on a YouTube video. I mean, first off, I'm recording sound directly off the Sony camera, so you're only going to get so good there. Secondly, you've got YouTube compression going on, and that drastically affects the sound. And then finally, you're listening through computer speakers or maybe earphones. So, you know, you're really not going to get a sense of it off of a video, and that's why I don't do sound samples on these particular videos. If you want to get an approximation, kind of, sort of, maybe almost close, you can listen to any of the lesson videos that I've done with Eddie, and you can get a sense there. But the best way for you to hear how this bass sounds, and also how well it plays, is to go to your closest Spector dealer, have them pull one down off the wall, and plug it into your favorite amp. Then you're going to know what it sounds like for you. And you're also going to get to find out how wonderful the neck is. And that's one of the things I've always loved about Spector, is that their necks are absolutely fabulous. Just flawless feel. And they've got this thing set up so low, I think the only thing lower in the world is in the Netherlands, and they're below sea level. But just plays like a dream, feels like butter, and just sounds so wonderful. And I'm so pleased to have Etta in my collection of Spectors. I'm up to 3 now and going to be heading for 4 as quick as I can. So anyway, this is Etta, my Spector Coda-5. I've been endorsing Spector for over 16 years now, and there's nothing on the planet that I think comes even close. And I really want to strongly encourage you to go down to your Spector dealer, check them out, see which model is best for you. I'm Lane on Bass. Y'all keep thumping. Peace.